Time magazine describes it as a first-of-its-kind library of potential coronavirus drugs. Quote, with a $2.1 million starting grant from Chinese technology mogul Jack Ma, Dr. David Ho will oversee four research teams at Columbia University whose goal is to find an effective treatment against COVID-19 and other coronaviruses. And if you're pursuing a project like this, Dr. David Ho might be exactly the person you want overseeing it. His groundbreaking HIV research changed the course of the AIDS epidemic worldwide in the 1990s. He's been researching and fighting viruses ever since. Dr. Ho is now scientific director and CEO of the Aaron Diamond AIDS Research Center, and I'm very pleased to say that he joins us now here on set. Dr. Ho, you are far away from me at this desk, but that's on purpose. Thank you for being here.
A pleasure.
I know that you were able to hear my introduction a minute ago, and I don't want to ask you to answer for all of it, but when I was talking about you and your research and questions about the coronavirus, I just want to ask you if I said anything that seemed wrong or wrongheaded to you.
No, you got it right.
Okay. We asked you today about things that you might want to convey to the American people, help people understand better about where we're at with this coronavirus problem. And you sent us these graphs, fairly simple graphs, and I walked through them a little bit. But can you describe what's important? We can put them up on the screen again. What's important about the shape that's evident in these graphs and what you see as a scientist looking at these?
Well, the first graph involved what happened in China and in South Korea. And you could see the epidemic just took off based on those daily case numbers and peaked around February 4th with 4,000 cases a day. But with the draconian measures implemented within central China, it got controlled. And it was dropping every week by half, very steadily. And this past week, I think there are only a handful of cases outside the central province of Hubei in a country of 1.2 billion. So that control is remarkable. And what was not on the graph is what's happening in various provinces and cities in China. And they were held under pretty tight control with no city or province over 1,500 cases. Hmm. And so what was done in China is quite remarkable. In South Korea, there was also a rather explosive epidemic that followed a few weeks later. And without implementing harsh measures, but by social distancing and good hygiene, they were able to bring it down, albeit with a slope that's not as sharp.
Very aggressive testing was also a characteristic of the South Korean response.
Yes, testing obviously is central. Mm-hmm. Without testing, you're blind. And if you have no tests, you have no cases. So the other graphs that show what happened in Italy and Spain occur weeks later, and it's following the same trend. It's an exponential growth, with Italy taking off first, but now Spain is following, and Germany and many Western European countries are going through the same thing. And then in New York, what we're seeing is just the beginning. Mm. So we're lagging behind another couple weeks. And if we think back, 11 days ago, we had the first case in New York City. And then there were a handful of cases every day for about a week. And then the 3 days ago, we're seeing cases in the teens. So that's the inflection point.
Part of what we're seeing here is as this moves through time, mm-hmm. we see different countries deal with it as it arrives and then takes off.
Right.
But part of what we're seeing here is that even when the raw numbers are different between individual, like between us and Italy, the raw numbers that you're talking about here in terms of measuring on these graphs are different. The shape of the curve being the same implies that we are headed in the same direction.
Right. We're just lagging behind by a certain period of time. Mm. China started over two months ago, Italy about 6 weeks ago, and we're just catching up. And this implies the same wave of epidemic could sweep through, let's say, middle America, which is lagging behind the New York area and the West Coast.
With the sort of scattershot mitigation measures that are starting to be implemented now in the United States, New York City schools, for example, are still open. with the lack of testing that we've got, which, as you say, leaves us blind in terms of how to target these sorts of measures. Do you think that the United States holds any hope of bending that curve down at this point? Or are we looking at explosive growth for the foreseeable future until we can do something radically different as a country?
Well, we have to remember the cases that were found yesterday in New York City represent what happened about a week ago. When transmission occurred. So what we're seeing is about a week behind. And of course, the virus could go through several rounds of spread and expand at least tenfold and maybe 20-fold. So what we see from yesterday is just the tip of the iceberg. And there's a huge mass that we cannot see.